Greetings and welcome to the Introduction to Astronomy. One of the things that I like to do in each of my introductory astronomy classes is to begin the class with the astronomy picture of the day from the NASA website that is apod.nasa.gov/apod. And today's picture for December the 24th of 2020, well, it is titled Portrait of NGC 1055. So what do we see here? Well, the main thing in the image that we see is a distant galaxy, and in fact, a relatively close one, only about 60 million light years away. And while that may seem like a tremendous distance, and when we consider that that means that the light that we're seeing from the galaxy left that galaxy over 60 million years ago, taking all that time to travel the immense distances between us and the galaxy, it is really relatively small compared to the entire size of the universe. So more distant galaxies could be a billion or 10 billion light years away, instead of just the few million light years that we're talking about here. Now we see this as an almost edge-on spiral galaxy, and we're looking at it turned sideways, and that allows us to see a lot more of the dust lanes going across the middle of the galaxy. And in fact, it may remind you of images of our own galaxy, our own Milky Way. Because of our positioning within our Milky Way, we essentially see our Milky Way edge-on as well. So we can't look down directly and see the spiral arms. We can certainly infer that they are there in this galaxy by the galaxy type, by the signs of star formation, the pinkish areas that we see as associated with star forming regions, that where stars are actually exciting hydrogen gas that is left over from around them. Now, also in the image, we see a number of stars, and in fact, a couple of bright stars down towards the bottom, or at least relatively bright stars for this image. And those are stars within our own Milky Way. So they are much closer than the distant galaxy. And in fact, within our Milky Way, so we're talking, you know, thousands of light years away, perhaps, depending on the specific star. And if we look at those three relatively bright ones towards the bottom, we can see that they are three distinctly different colors. Now, the color of a star tells us about its temperature. The colors of gases really don't tell us that. They tell us more about the composition of the gas. But here we can learn about the temperatures of the stars. So to the left, we see two stars, one below very blue, one above and to the right very red. And the blue star is a very hot star, emitting much more energetic radiation than the red star up above it. So that blue star might have a temperature several times the temperature of our sun, whereas the redder star might be about half the temperature of our sun. Now that's to compare to the bright star on the right hand side and below the galaxy, in that that is much more of a yellowish star and probably something similar in temperature to our own sun. So by looking at the temperature for stars, we can actually learn about the temperatures of them. Looking at the different colors in our galaxy does not necessarily tell us that, as that pink glow of hydrogen gas does not tell us anything about the temperatures, but instead tells us about the composition that we see. However, the bluish glow of blue stars that we see in a ridge up behind, kind of just be above and behind the galaxy, would be the combined light of many blue stars and would tell us about the temperatures of those stars. So in astronomy, sometimes the colors are able to tell us things about objects such as stars. But when we start looking at nebulae, it becomes quite different, and we can learn lots of different things depending on the exact situation. So that was our picture of the day for December the 24th of 2020. It was titled Portrait of NGC 1055. We'll be back again tomorrow for the next picture, previewed to be Postcard from the North. So we'll see what that is about tomorrow. And until then, have a great day, everyone, and I will see you in class.